Hey, did you know that you can customize your Unity game's splash screen even in the personal edition? It is super easy to implement in your own project, no matter when in your production cycle. All we need is to set up a few entries in the project settings. Go to Build Settings, Player Settings, and into the drop-down labeled Splash Image. Ignore the first box if your game is not made for virtual reality. As you can see, on personal, you cannot turn off the splash screen. Thus, this option is grayed out. By clicking here, you'll get a preview of your screen without having to build your game. You are going to use this a lot. First, logos. Here is a list of your logos. Drop them in and adjust the order of them as needed. You might need more than just your own logo for your project, in case you chose to work with certain third-party applications, for example. You can change how long each logo should be visible with the sliders, and Unity will tell you how long the complete screen will be visible down here. I'm going to type in 10 seconds to get a better preview of the effects for you. Let's give it a try, and well, that looks kinda off balance, doesn't it? This screen feels strangely top-heavy, and my logo looks a bit too big, at least to me. This is because the box your logo is placed in and centered into looks like this. On a 1920 by 1080 monitor, this box is about 430 pixels high and can have a width of approximately 1200 pixels. This box is placed 110 pixels from the top and about 540 from the bottom to still leave room for the Unity logo in this case. For your logo, this means it will be positioned and centered at 320 pixels from the top. To make it look more pleasing to the eye, you will need to add some white space to your logo file. Make a new file in your graphics editing application of choice with a height of 430 pixels and a width of up to 1200 pixels, depending obviously on the orientation of your logo. Place your logo into it, resize it to something you'd call reasonable, and place it further down towards the lower end of the image. You might have to give it a few tries and adjustments to find the size and position you'd like. I drop mine in and yeah, this looks good enough for me. Another way is to have the logos set one after the other. And again, you can customize the order in which they'll show up. If you show your logo like this, though, it will take up almost the whole screen. A square logo, for example, will have the size of 860 by 860 pixels, about double the size from before. This time, it will be centered, too. Scaling it down works the same as before. Make the background transparent, drop your logo in, and resize as needed. I would suggest you keep it centered this time, as you cannot change where the Unity logo will be placed. That will stay at the center of the screen, and thus a differently placed logo of your own might give your splash screen a bit of visual confusion. Onwards to the background. This seriously hideous greyish-brown urgently needs to go, doesn't it? You have two options for this. The first and easiest one is to choose a basic color here, or you can use your own image. I created a background image in the maximum screen size I would support for this project. Make sure your background is horizontal instead of vertical if you don't plan to have a vertical game. Unity's toolset doesn't support you in cropping your image, so you'll need to do so in your own graphics application. Drop your image into the project, into the dedicated slot, and give it a preview. Your splash screen should already look so much better by now, but we can tweak further. For example, here, you can choose to blur your background or show it as a clear image. For my project, I choose to use the clear one, because this game looks like it uses crisp lines and hard contrasts in it, and any kind of blur wouldn't fit those graphics at all. This is the first screen players see of your game, so make sure it doesn't just look good, but also fits how your game will look too. Another option is to choose between dark on light and light on dark. This is great to set a first mood to. The dark on light is perfect for a friendly, cozy game with a light color palette. Unity's logo automatically switches from a white to a black one in this case, but you might have to adjust your own logos accordingly. Lastly, you can customize some movement on the screen. The standard dolly gives you a bit of zoom effect on logo and background alike. Static is hopefully self-explanatory. But custom is interesting. Here you can set values to how much your logos or your background should be animated. Play around with these numbers. The effects can look quite nice. I'll stay with logo zoom to 0 and background zoom to 1. This movement fits the following main menu the best, I think. And that's it. Now go out and dazzle your players with a custom splash screen that actually fits your game. Had you known about this already? Did I answer all the questions you had or didn't know you had? Let me know, I'd love to hear from you.